If your renderings aren't coming out quite how you were hoping, sometimes the smallest tweaks can make the biggest difference. In this video, I'll show you 10 practical tips that'll instantly make your renders look way more realistic. We'll look at real examples and highlight exactly what changed so that you can implement these tips into your designs. Before we dive in, please show some love to that like button, and don't forget to try out the free pro trial where you can unlock all of the best tools for high quality renders. Lighting is one of the biggest factors in how realistic your renders look. If your lighting is too dim, it can cause these distortions. And this fixture is overly yellow, which is something you can fix in the settings. Overall, it makes the entire room feel dull and unrealistic. Lighting with the right white balance and soft ambient light gives the room depth and makes textures and materials more visual and lifelike. In this example, there are way too many competing light sources, making the scene feel chaotic and overexposed. Just simplifying the lighting setup and adjusting intensity brings harmony back to the space. The focus returns to the design, not the light fixtures. Always make sure your textures are scaled correctly. This tile flooring is way too large, which throws off the proportions and distracts from the overall layout. Rescaling the tiles to match real-world dimensions makes the space feel grounded and believable. In this example, you can see where the wood texture starts to repeat itself. Just swapping it out for a seamless wood texture adds grain and variation, making the room feel warm and natural. Avoid leaving your room looking unfinished or too bare. This space feels cold and uninviting with almost no decor or personal touches. Just a few accessories, a rug, painting, a pillow, instantly makes the room feel warmer and more lived in. The wrong camera angle can ruin an otherwise great design. Here you can see the camera is positioned too low at a weird angle and cuts through the walls, making the layout unclear. Setting the camera at eye level and framing the main design elements gives the space balance and focus. Repeating identical decor elements makes your render feel staged and artificial. Multiple identical flowers or identical decor can create an unrealistic sense of symmetry. Sometimes just varying the size, position, and style of these items adds a more natural, lived-in look. Don't leave your windows empty or blank. It breaks the illusion of a real space. Adding an outdoor scene like a garden, park, or city view adds context and makes the room feel like it's part of a real world. Personally, I find it more distracting when the view outside of a window is just completely blank. Planner 5D has quite a few background images to choose from. We also have a few more tips going over background design, and you can find that video here. Always try and take your reflections into account before rendering your design. In this example, you can see the sky of the background, and that's because this wall has been hidden. So to fix this, all you have to do is show the wall by clicking the eye icon. If you end up needing a little extra room to set up your render, you can easily move the wall back. This will ensure that the room stays closed while also giving you enough space to place the render camera. Objects that don't touch the ground or sit correctly can ruin the realism of your design. You'll notice here that all of these items just aren't where they're supposed to be. So making sure every item sits properly makes the scene feel grounded and physically believable. Sometimes designing for looks only and not for real life use can make renders feel off. In this example, the kitchen counter isn't optimized for seating, which would be really uncomfortable realistically. So adjusting to real world ergonomic standards ensures the design is both usable and believable. Sometimes less really is more. Here, there's just too much going on. Simplifying your design choices and creating clear focal points helps viewers appreciate the space without distraction. And there you have it, 10 tips to help you create the most realistic renders. Before you go, let's just do a quick little recap. Make sure to incorporate balanced lighting. Add properly scaled textures to add dimension and depth. Be thoughtful with your decor placement. Use natural camera angles. Try mixing and matching different types of decor. Make the most of your render by incorporating backgrounds to give a view. Keep all walls visible so that you get proper reflections. Ensure your items use the right levitation so they don't float. Make sure your designs are actually functional. Sometimes less is more. Don't be afraid to simplify your design to create a focal point. Which tip was your favorite? Let us know in the comments. If you found this helpful, please give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. As always, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye.